This isn't going to be a motivational story. This is reality. My journey to the top. March 2016. I wanted to start my journey way earlier, as every little big thing affected the timeline and made me, me. The biggest turning point in my timeline was my 10th result. I am from Selur. Most of you haven't even heard of it yet. I studied in Deepchand Chaudhary Vidyalaya Selur. Being the topper there, my 10th result wasn't very shocking. The shocking part comes afterwards. My mummy and papa both are teachers. With no one from doctor's background, my journey in NEET started looking for advertisements in newspaper. My uncle was a big help in that. Fast forward to June 2016. I was in Wankhede Madams Academy, one of the top coaching institutes for NEET in Nagpur. Why NEET? There are two reasons. One, it was something no one in my family had done before. I loved the thrill of venturing into the unknown. Two, it was to fulfill the dream of my parents. Let's not get too senti. Back to the coaching classes. Remember the whooping success I got in 10th standard? Turns out everyone in that class had almost the same, if not better, score. To tell you the truth, I was pretty less than average there. Why? Did I mention that I was in semi-English school? My first language was Marathi, and I wasn't the best English speaker in the world. Not to mention, being from the village makes you different from the city boys. You know what I mean, right? I had to adjust to a lot of things. My introverted nature did not make it easy at all. So, tell me, what do you get when you add introverted village kid, coaching classes in the city, living alone in the hostel? You get failure. My first class test. It was nothing but basic logbook questions. I couldn't even touch the halfway mark. The results used to be posted on a big notice board with everyone's name on it. And I was like, नीचे से चेक कर नीचे से. It wasn't a very pleasant experience. Next day in class, AC felt irritating. Too cold. The teachers were teaching in English. My dressing sense? If there would be a fashion show, I would be the first. From the bottom. Doing classes in the morning from 6:30 to 12:30. Then coming back to my Taj Hotel like 5-star room. Studying. Still, nothing. I felt very dumb. I used to go home every week. By the way, Selu is just 2-hour journey from Nagpur. Going back home felt like I was released from some super horrific jail. काळ्या पाण्याची शिक्षा माहिती आहे का तुम्हाला? तसंच काहीतरी. Come Saturday, I was at home. On Sunday, I had to go back to Nagpur. Up until now, this story feels kind of depressing, right? Are you waiting for a turning point? Maybe some test that has scored 100 on 100. Maybe some great talks from a big personality. Maybe some accident, some lottery. Universe doesn't work that way, my friend. Before my eyes, it blocks my path. A high wall. What sort of scene is on the other side, I wonder. What will I be able to see there? The view from the top. A scenery I will never be able to see on my own. But if I'm not alone, then I might be able to see it. I had my parents rooting for me at home, my sister who looked up to me, and of course some people who taunted me saying I couldn't do it. A stupid teenager all alone in a big city wanting to leave a mark. It was gradual. A few marks more in test. A few more talks with classmates. A bit more command on the subject. It took me months to reach to the top. Or so I want to say. Nope. The reality was that I was still okay-ish. With so much flapping, this little birdie finally caught up to the group. Even then, stupid things kept on happening in my life. Quarrel with roommate, teasing, boys saying this and this girl likes you. A very terrible tiffin. Oh, the food was. Going to the police station for nothing. That is a story for some other time. Half a year passed. I was finally playing in the top 30 of my class. Just as things were going smoothly, 11th standard college exams were announced. I was from Dr. Ambedkar College, Nagpur. No proxy, no cheating allowed. Only sincere tests. I excelled in the exam. First rank in DACN 11th standard filled my balloon-like head with pride. But the test papers going on in coaching classes made lots of holes too. College exams had taken their toll. I was back to the bottom again. I've been saying a lot of times, I topped this, I was good at that, and yet I say that I am an average student. Am I stupid or are you a fool? My friend, all humans are not created equal. Some people can memorize pages in a single reading. Others need days to learn just one formula. Average is someone who needs 3 to 5 readings to learn one answer. Average is me. It's not like I got bad score in one or two tests. I kept on getting worse. Weeks passed, then months. 12th teaching started. I couldn't seem to recover. I couldn't get back to the top. I felt like a fish, gasping for breath out on the riverbank. Late night studying, revised chapters time and time again, solving hundreds of MCQ. Nothing seemed to work. And the syllabus kept on piling up. I was at my breaking point. The only thing that kept me going was, well, it wasn't one thing. Remember, I told you, it's not a movie, it's reality. It was a song for some days, a motivational quote, some cheers and advices from my friends. Life keeps going on. I desperately kept holding on to anything I could. What was constant then? The belief in myself. Those were some bad days, but they had fun of their own too. Late night ice cream, football, Maggie, rains, and a lot of it. It was finally time for Diwali vacation. I took a complete break of studies, enjoying at home, got my mind fresh. Vacations ended in a blink. I was back to where I started, in the coaching classes, struggling with test papers. But this time, I had my own magic weapon, experience. I wasn't starting from zero. I had a foundation of my own experience. I tried improving, a few marks at a time. Slowly, I climbed, 1 ranks, 2 ranks, 3 ranks, and finally, I was again playing at the top. Being weak means there is room to grow. Being average means there is room at the top. Fast forward to the D-Day, the day my NEET exam was scheduled. That night, we went to the local club, drunk a lot, had some beer and danced. That's what happens in movies, right? For me, it was going to the nearest general store, getting fruity, drinking, having fun, and late night talks. I think you might relate. I just couldn't sleep that night. The next day, I was up and early at 5 in the morning. I got off the bed, went to the bakery, got myself some milk, a bottle of fruity and a packet of Britannia cake. I still remember. For some reason, I got pure veg one. Being away from home means you have to be happy in these little things. My center of NEET, Vayusena Nagar. Half an hour journey from Lakshmi Nagar. I did not read a single word that day. I just kept on humming the same song from the morning to the exam. Same song over and over again to keep my mind relaxed. It was time. I called the cab. But the universe had a last minute twist to my story. All the cabs were busy. I couldn't find anyone. Fortunately, I untwisted the twist of the universe. You know, when a door closes in your life, try knocking harder. Maybe the person on the other side will get annoyed and open it for you. It worked with the cab for me. Everyone gets a scheduled time to reach the center. You go in, you get checked like you have a nuclear bomb in your pocket. I had to break away the buttons of my t-shirt and the hooks of my pant too. With nothing but hall ticket in hand, I went inside. All the NEET aspirants. In the heat of May, from 8:30 to 10. Such factors matter a lot, you know. The heat, the waiting, the condition in the center, and kids never prepare for it. A lot of us got anxious, hesitant, even sick. I was the same, humming the same song, looking around for trees, maybe a bench, a chair, a blank wall, anything that doesn't move, anything I could fix my eyes on. My friends, the difference between you getting a government MBBS or a private MBBS lies on the very day of exam. Being focused is the key. It was time. I was sitting in the exam hall and the formalities were being done. You know, signing, checking, some more checking and more checking. I sometimes wonder, do they do these checking just to disturb ourselves? There was the neat paper, the specially issued pens. It was over in no time at all. 3 hours passed by in a blink. Just as I was coloring the last bubble, I knew I screwed in chemistry. But I got the better of physics. When the exam is about to end, when you're about to darken the last bubble of your answer sheet, you already know where you stand. You already know what marks you're going to get. You sort of know what result is going to be. And I was out, smiling. Who am I kidding? A dehydrated, hypoglycemic, sleepy, sunken-eyed teenager walked out from the classroom. On that very day, I packed my bags from the room and got back home. Checked my answers from the tentative answer sheet, you know, the one that uploads after that paper. Well, long story short, here I am, Abhijit Raghatate, NEET All India Rank 2702, a student from the prestigious Government Medical College, Nagpur, the top ranker from my college in the first year. Hell yeah, I started my med life with a bang. More on it some other time. Whatever you need in your life to be successful, the hope, the determination, the power, it's right here, behind the fourth intercostal space, resting and beating like it should be from the day you were born. The rest of it fits right in the skull. Just about 1500 ml of gooey electrical matter. Use it. Get successful. My best wishes. This is Abhijit signing out. Bye bye.